Hello everybody, how are you? Today we are going to talk about how live streaming can amplify your customer reach and engagement in digital of business and business of digital. We are very lucky to have somebody who has been producer and partner of live shows, host of shows for last 5 years. Grace is here with us. Grace has been working with Social Media Examiner and Restream. She has been virtual events manager at Restream right now. Grace, can you just brief us a bit more about what has been your journey?
Absolutely, Sahil. Thank you for having me today. So yes, I have been involved in live streaming for several years. So I am currently the virtual events manager at Restream, which means that I manage all of our sponsorships at industry events, both big and large. And then I also look after some of our top tier video producers, experts and pros on that host weekly and biweekly shows on the Restream channels. And so you can see that on Restream's YouTube page, Facebook, LinkedIn. So you'll see people like Stephanie Liu, Gloria Petrucci from Live Streaming Pros, all of that. And then you can also see these shows on LinkedIn. I'm also a producer and partner on a new social media news show called Social Media News Live. You can also find that on YouTube and Facebook, and it's also a podcast. And on that show, we also cover the latest social media marketing news. So I've been in live streaming and doing this for quite some time.
Yes. So did you start your journey in live streaming and did you start your journey as a producer? What was the
earlier part? No, I started working in digital marketing about 20 years ago, back in the MySpace and Yahoo 360 days, if you can believe it. So I started in traditional advertising. I wanted to make television ads, to tell you the truth. And, you know, I was very young and ambitious, and you know, this was several years ago. And so they were like, hey, here's this young kid on the account. Get rid of all this digital stuff. It's not going to matter. You know, they were like, people were spending money on like big TV productions, newspaper ads, magazines. They're like, what is that, this digital stuff? So that pretty much launched my career into online marketing. I've worked with several agencies. I've worked with several brands. I've been on all sides of this. And I even launched my own agency at one point with four of my friends. And I've had the privilege of working with some really amazing companies. And then over time, I ended up working for Social Media Examiner on their editorial team. And that led me into producing and co-hosting eventually the social media marketing talk show for them. And, you know, and then here we are at Restream.
It's a great journey. And the growth that you say, that people gave you things just because digital was not so prominent at that time is what has happened with a lot of people who initially jumped into it just because they were curious. People who were good in SEO right now or have seen a lot of things, they wanted to do it because they were experimental and nobody was able to take that up. And that is why it landed in their pocket.
Yep, absolutely.
When we talk about live streaming, which is the topic today, and why is it important, what is the textbook definition of live streaming for the audience?
Okay, so live streaming, as you know, on several social media platforms, you can basically pick up your mobile device or get on a camera or get on a platform and go live to your audience on Facebook, on YouTube, on LinkedIn, on Periscope and Twitter Live. You can go live on Twitch. So with our tool at Restream Studio tool, you can go live to up to 30 different destinations online simultaneously. So essentially what that means is that you turn on the camera and you start talking. Of course, it's not that simple, but you know, that's basically it, right? At the basic level, you get on camera and and it's instantaneous. So as we're broadcasting this live, as we are talking and, you know, speaking to each other on video, our audience is seeing it just as it's happening, which means that they see the good parts, they see the mistakes, they see when we talk over each other. It's a really organic and a highly engaging experience.
True. When it comes to live streaming, which are the kind of live streaming that people can do? And what are, so there are a lot of platforms. Facebook does live, Instagram has its own live, YouTube has its own live, LinkedIn also has live, but we need permission for doing that. Which are the kind of ways or should I articulate it in a way? What are the formats of going live?
Yeah, well, you just mentioned all the different platforms. So with our Restream Studio tool, you can go live to all of those places simultaneously. So, you know, if you were just going live on Facebook, you would turn on your Facebook app or your Facebook, you know, you go to the page, yes, you press record, but then you're only going live to Facebook, right? But if you're going to go live and you're going to reach your audience, why not go to YouTube and LinkedIn if you have the permission, and Twitter as well, and Twitch, yes, or wherever else your audience is. And so that by doing that, you expand your reach, you're basically meeting your audience where they're at and they're able to catch it. And of course, once the live is done, it stays there and you can either keep it up there or you can edit and re-upload it as a video, but it stays up there for as long as you want to. And so when you are doing something on live and like, let's say a product announcement or a product demo or something, it lives there for as long as you want it to live there, continuing to bring value to your audience.
Very true. Very true. Which are the ways in which people can produce things, or what are the things that people can do in a live video? So there are different formats. There are different ways. You hosted a talk show. You have you're coming up with a show that we discuss. So like we are also doing it. It's a two-person show. It's an interview kind of thing. What are different ways in which people can go live, and what are the things that they should keep in mind?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Of course. So usually when people think about going live, they think they're going to pick up their phone and they're going to just start talking, you know, whatever. I am not someone that can just randomly start talking. I really need to know what we're talking about, and I need a script, and I need to know, well, not necessarily a script, but I just at least need to know the flow. Pointless. And I need to understand, what we're doing, right? And so, you know, for a lot of people, that's not, that's kind of hard to adapt to, or they're not used to it, or you can't predict the environment. So there are a lot of different ways in which you can utilize live video. One of them is one-on-one video calls. So in Restream, we have a studio product, which functions just like Zoom. You know, there's a web address I send to you. And then within that, you're launched into a web experience. And within that, you can brand it. You could put your captions, you can put a lot of graphics. And so anyone that has an agency or deals with clients, it's a really really good experience and a good way to really show off the capabilities of your company. So we use our live streaming tools to do a lot of one-on-one calls. It's definitely how you and I first met, right?
True.
Of course. You know, you can also do educational webinars. So now that people are unable to meet in person, webinars, online digital webinars and seminars are all the rage. And so this is, you know, it's another way in which you have the presenters going live. They are speaking to your audience directly. It's the same. Well, I don't want to say it's the same experience, but it does replicate that experience of being in an in-person conference, and you get to have that conversation. So as we're doing this talk show, as we're going live, you know, people would be able to ask us questions and like, oh, let's answer this question. And it's a more interactive experience. You know, same thing with the live talk show interview. You know, Restream hosts a whole slate of these live videos broadcast on our channel. We have them about four to five days a week, and you can see them in action where we have a guest and we have a topic, we have a guest, and we talk about those things on live camera. And then from there, you can repurpose those. You know, you can definitely do live streaming presentations. So there's a local shop where I live, where every Tuesday, the owner of the shop gets on live camera. It's totally unscripted. And she's just showing you the new merchandise that came in, right? We have had several case studies in which agencies have used live streaming as a way to showcase their products, to give a behind the scenes look, to give people real taste of what's going on within the company, and to generate that interest in what they're doing.
True. So when we see there are different ways of going live, and so that happens with a lot of people, that they consume a lot of things online with a lot of bandwidth. There's a lot of information also. So what is the advantage, what you feel is, because if you go to YouTube and type digital marketing, you will get a lot of things. If you go to, if you just type baseball, you will get a lot of videos. You like Ronaldo, you will get a lot of. So what is the major advantage which you feel live videos give you? Because videos are everywhere, information is everywhere. How important is it for people to go live, and what are the things which you feel is why live is going so high now?
Well, I think the number one advantage, at least what I've seen, is that it allows you to position yourself as a professional, as an expert in your industry, right? So you mentioned baseball, right? Yes. So if I was a baseball commentator and I really want to tell you that I really want to show off to you that I'm the expert in baseball. I have a business that's involved in baseball. I really want you to see it. Then being live and having someone interview you and being able to answer all of these questions about baseball quickly and succinctly and in an entertaining and engaging manner really positions you as the expert in that space. And I think the same is true if you're a marketer, if you're, you know, selling clothes in a local boutique, if you're, you know, selling shoes, if you're selling dog food, you know, it's just, it really positions you in that space. It allows you to connect with your community and with a relatively low bar, right? So it allows you to be vulnerable. It allows you to be human. It allows you to be imperfect. So if you're seeing trends over the last few years in social media, you know that we started off with everything being very highly polished, right? I mentioned that I worked at an ad agency and the number of people that it took to make a 30-second ad was ridiculous, right? We're talking like millions and millions of dollars. Well, you and I could do a 30-second ad right now, right? We've got the creativity, we've got the knowledge, you know, it allows you to do all of that with a fairly low budget. And so anyone can do it, right? Anyone can go live, you know, and you'll see that people tend to, the trend now tends to be, people want to be a little bit scruffy. They want to see things to be real. You know, we want to see dogs and kids running into the video. And that was just like nothing you would have done before, right? It's also very relatable and uplifting. It's the same thing as, you know, having, you know, you and I being in the room together and connecting this way. And it also enables you as a brand to meet your customers. So one of the really awesome things that we do at Restream is every Wednesday we do a live product demonstration and Q&A. And it is a rapid fire conversation in which people that use our product, that have questions about it, are coming to us with their questions. And we are, our support team and our marketing team are right there answering them, opening up their own studio site, figuring out what the problem is, and it allows you to meet those customer needs. Well, we also use that as, you know, even if we don't answer every question, well, now you have a list of everything that your customers want. And we use that to improve our product, to create new updates, to roll out enhancements, right? So it's a way for us to also connect and find out what it is that our audience, what is it that our customers really need from us. And, you know, and it isn't a format, it isn't a survey. They're just coming live to talk to you. Yeah. And that's another way that our customers also feel heard.
So best part which I like about live streaming is it makes things two-way possible. Because somebody's commenting, you are reading that comment live and then you are answering them. And those kind of features and those kind of things help people to be more human. And I have seen that in a lot of summits and a lot of conferences, webinars, that because it is two-way, people feel more connected. Because when things were offline, they were seeing something, they used to ask questions and then they used to get it answered. And with live streaming, it is, I think everything is not replicated, but most of the part is getting replicated in that way.
Yeah. Absolutely. Can you imagine having to send an email with your customer? I mean, tell me to send an email or make a phone call. I'm like, I'm done. I'm out. I can't do this. So, but I can comment on your Facebook video, and that's the way that we interact. And it's a valuable way for companies and brands or agencies to reach their audience.
True, true. So once we go online, we do things live. We have our good camera setup. We have selected a format. What should be done after we have gone live, the video is out? What are the things which should be done afterwards when the video is there?
Oh, there's several things you can do. And all of these will take under an hour each week. I promise you, right? With the right tools and everything. So the easiest thing, I think, is to then distribute your live video as an audio podcast, right? You put on an intro, you put on an outro, you can edit the video down to, you know, that lag time in the beginning and then that final time at the end. And then, you know, as you're also recording, at least in the Restream tool, as you're recording, you see where your audience can go up and down. Now that number, you know, it can make you a little crazy, right? Because you see the audience going up and down. But that's valuable because then you see where did your audience kind of drop off or where they lag. You can edit that part out. Edit that part out and then distribute that as a podcast. You can also take that video and re-upload it as a as a shorter version of the video, right? So then you have this like edited and polished, and you get the benefit of both the live video and the interacting with the audience, but then continuing to provide value. You can also take that video and provide clips and teasers that you could then use on social media. So what we do on social media news live is that we'll take clips, we'll take those very smart nuggets that our guests have said, and we turn them into social media videos, right? Like little 30-second clips with the graphics, with the logo. And, you know, you can use, we use After Effects and then Premiere, which are both Adobe products to produce those things. And at least my co-host there, the guy hosting it now, makes it look really easy. But I think it is. So you can also distribute them as audiograms. So you could take that and take that audio and upload it into a Instagram story, or get it post or repost on TikTok and share it. And you just share the audio. Yeah. And it's a very eye-catching thing because it's like audio and you've got your visual. And then after we go live, you can also save it as an IGTV post.
Yes.
And we've recently noticed that you get a lot more traction and better engagement when you convert a live video into an IGTV. And that has to do with the fact that right now Instagram is putting a lot of investment into IGTV, and then also Reels, which is their TikTok product, right?
Yeah.
So those are some things that you can do, just really quick social media clips. You know, you can distribute parts of the video or the entire video as part of your email campaign as a lead generator for your company.
Yes.
You're providing value, you're getting right in people's inboxes. You can upload it to your company website or blog, continue using it as a blog post. And then also you can redistribute this, your business webinars and presentations. And then my favorite thing, my absolute favorite thing, and you can do this, is to create branded gifts with your video clips. So, you know, we do these like silly little things, you know, gifts have become the way that people communicate or the react to things. And I know there's a tool called Giphy where you can easily create your own gifts. And I'm sure there's several others, and I'm sure people that are truly designers, I am not one, would be able to direct you a better place. But you can take these video clips of you making a face or you doing something, or those silly moments, those blooper mistake moments, and turn them into funny gifts that are branded for your company. And so when someone needs a gift, there's your company name, there's your company brand, right? And then they're using it as to communicate with people. I use GIFs all the time, by the way.
So there are two types of new economy which are coming up. One is meme economy, another is GIF economy in that So GIFs have been used a lot, and a lot of colleges are also coming up. So if you see MIT, UCLA, and a lot of them, a lot of baseball brands are using it. Big brands are onto it because that is the, I think, medium of expression for a lot of people. As you said, you use it a lot. And then there are a lot of different players who are trying to use it. And truly said that repurposing the content which has been created once is very important, like you have explained us. I think the last part was the best. Thanks a lot for sharing that. we had seen that.
Yeah, I've seen that. So I know there's several of our influencers that we work with. We work with over 500 influencers at Restream, each, you know, talking about our product or using it themselves. And so there are several of them who've created GIFs. And the other day I wanted to share this. I was frustrated about something, right? And then my friend, Kelly Maribella Noble, she's a messaging bot developer. Her face came up, and I was like, "This is perfect." So you can get really creative with it. You can use, and I think it's just a funny way to make the most of. Oh, you know, if you were to spill something or do something like make a face, you know, those things that you're normally self-conscious about. Well, turn it into a GIF. Make it fun.
True. And this is a smarter way of reaching a lot of people, because a lot of people are using GIFs a lot, and you might end up in their feed without paying or doing any of those sorts. And the brand recognition is very high in those things.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah, especially if you're a personal brand, right? And this is your product, right?
So. Yeah, this much is our product.
This is my product.
Very true. So live streaming is here to stay. That is what a lot of people say. Gaming as an industry has evolved a lot. What do you think, how live streaming, due to this lockdown and those things, what kind of impact has live streaming as a general, because you have been in Restream and you have seen things go up and down, I think. What is your feedback, or what is your thing which you have noticed in last 2 years, how the industry has shifted?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think I want to talk to you about the things that are coming up, right? So yeah, the big thing I have to tell you is live shopping. So at least every single platform has dabbled in live shopping, primarily Facebook and Instagram when they launched live shopping and shops mid-year last year, and they yes, started rolling out. And then now it's the live shopping, right? So what this is the ability to go live, right? And to do your video, showcase your products. And then right there at the bottom, or right there within the app, they can buy it right from your Facebook shop or from your Instagram shop. And it's a product, right? TikTok has been experimenting this. They did a Holiday Spectacular. It was a partnership with, you know, global retailer Walmart, right? Yes. Where they worked with their influencers to create a holiday shopping experience where they were within a shop, they're pulling just merchandise out of the store, putting it together, and you could buy it right there within the TikTok app. YouTube is also experimenting with this. I just saw this last week that Shopify has furthered their commitments. And so live shopping is here to stay. So I think as long, and not everyone has access to this right now, but we should be preparing for it. We should be preparing for how do we sell on live video, right, in an engaging way, right? Another trend that I see a lot more of is cross-posting. So, you know, we just talked about all the ways that you can take yes, your live video and repurpose that. So we're going to see more and more of that as all of the channels become the same and also trying to differentiate themselves. So of course, you know, there's Snapchat, Instagram, and then TikTok, right? You know, that whole trend of like, now they're just kind of copying each other. So, you know, you're only visible for a certain number of hours or days when you're on Facebook, right?
Yes.
But then, and then you get drowned out by incoming content just because of the influx. And I would say the same for YouTube as well. Although YouTube does have that searchability. So if you were to do a video on, I don't know, how to unclog your drains or how to unfreeze your pipes or whatever, well, you know that people are going to, like, with as much SEO, and when you've got it positioned and you've edited that really good video, it's going to continue to provide value. Video on LinkedIn has been proving to be very effective. And I don't know how active you are on LinkedIn, but I'm seeing content on there when I log on. It's content that's been there for a week, right? Yes. So I'm now seeing it as a week, which means that that content has been sitting there for a week and I'm just now engaging with it, discovering it for the first time. And so you have a longer tail on that. And then Pinterest, videos on there have been known to continue to gain traction for 2 years.
Yes.
So, you know, so the more platforms that you can produce video for, create it, and then target it for that audience, the better reach. Because so you could post something on Facebook and post that same post some version of it on YouTube, LinkedIn, and Pinterest, and you're going to get so much more longevity than if you just post it on Facebook, if you just put it on TikTok, if you just put it on Instagram, right? You know, you and I touched on this a little bit too. We're going to see a lot more unscripted, more entertainment, you know, engaging more raw user-generated content, creating experiences. Now, I've been in advertising for a long time, and, you know, the way that it was you created this experience that drew people in, right?
Yeah.
Now the trend is that people don't want to be drawn into your experience. They want you to be part of theirs. Right. Yes. So you're going to see a lot more where brands are going to have to find a way to be part of the things that people are already experiencing. And you see that with meme culture, right? So a meme goes around and you know, you want to jump
every
on it.
Brand is coming on it.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I don't know if you saw this list last week, but Weetabix, you know, the brand Weetabix, they created an ad in which you could put baked beans on Weetabix. And for some reason, it just went viral, right? Right. And then so other brands started reacting to it and commenting and being part of it, right? And then you know that somewhere, I feel this person, somewhere there's some social media examiner or social media manager who put an email to their boss, can we make a meme about this? And you got to react, right? So it's too late now, right? And then I think finally, you're going to see a lot more more purpose-driven and more diversity within within the things that you produce. You know, I work for a global company, so you know, I'm very much aware that you know, there is a world outside of my own culture, outside of my own place, and so brands are going to have to find a way to to help their customers. You know, customers are really wanting to invest in brands that reflect their views and reflect their identity, and so as you're creating content, that's something that people should also keep in mind. I think it's probably the most important thing for the coming year.
So the last part where values are very important is, I think, going to be the most important thing which a lot of people have to make sure that they keep in mind in the next coming year. Because of the things which have happened in last 1 year, 1.5 years, we have seen things going out of hand a lot of times. And with extremes, getting all the access to internet and the platforms, it is becoming day by day more and more, I think, tough for people to understand that this is how there's a decorum which we need to maintain online in that way. Mm-hmm. Great. Mm-hmm. So there we have talked about a lot of things, Grace. And I think these are important aspects which people need to understand.
I think you froze.
Okay. Is it okay?
Sorry. Yeah. I think it froze a little bit.
Okay. So we have been doing or talking about these things a lot, and live stream is here to stay. What do you think about platforms like Twitch, which started off as a gaming platform and now they have an audience? There is a platform for Discord, which also was into gaming and now it has audience. YouTube is very big now in live streaming of games. Live streaming of esports is there. Live streaming of sports was always there, but now you see big players betting for these leagues, and so Facebook betting for IPL, which is Indian Premier League, which is one of the biggest sports in India. So suppose Facebook is betting for baseball league there. Those kind of things happening. What do you see? Think is going to be the future of these kind of things, where sports is getting online, e-gaming is coming up. Do you think it is going to be pushed a little more, or we are at a peak?
Oh, I absolutely do. Over the last year, Facebook in particular, you mentioned some of their investments. They have been really pushing gaming, and they've been pushing it to the forefront. I think gaming has become more ubiquitous now, where, you know, gaming used to be so intense and used to be so like, oh, I'm not a gamer, but now everyone games, right? So everyone, you know, from mobile casual games to just the very immersive experiences all the way to VR, right? Yeah. So the, you know, Facebook is owning Oculus. So I think this is being pushed more and more into the mainstream, and it's becoming more of a common thing. People like advertisers and marketers have started looking into esports and gaming for influencers. And they've actually been some really just strange partnerships, I think. So there was a, and I'm not going to say the name because I don't remember and I don't want to say the wrong one, but I know Louis Vuitton, the brand Louis Vuitton, actually partnered with a gamer on Twitch to promote their products. Now, you would never think that a luxury brand like
that.
Louis Vuitton would, one, need to advertise, and two, would go to Twitch, but that's the way that it is. And so, and you're seeing more and more of these partnerships, these brands, these luxury, these household, these lifestyle brands, getting more and more involved with this e-gaming, which you never would have thought would have happened a few years ago. So I think it's definitely something that if you have any interest in, any involvement in, or if you, even if you don't, get involved in it, because I think for marketers and for business owners, this is going to be a this is an untapped audience at the moment, right? So, of course, you know, there's all the brands that are involved with gaming, all the different things. But, you know, when you've got someone like Louis Vuitton reaching out to the gaming industry to find influencers, you know that this is a trend to watch.
Very true. And we talked a lot about trends and other things, but when we talk about trends, so this is a usual question which I asked to a lot of audience that we have on the show. How do you learn about these trends? What is your source of information? So where do you see, okay, this is happening, or where do you see these are the trends which Facebook has done, these are the things. Mm-hmm. How do you learn things which are around? What is your source of information?
Well, I've been following social media marketing news for the last 6.5 years. That was part of my role when I was at my previous company. So I would have to say that I watch a lot of news. I watch a lot of trends. I think as far as my favorite sources, if you're interested in live streaming and how to do that and what's new and what to do it, I would direct you to our YouTube channel on Restream and use that as a resource, because those are the people that I watch when it comes to live streaming. Those are the people that I ask questions to when I've got a question about live streaming. So yeah. I definitely think that. And then I've just been following social media trends for a while. I really think it comes down to you as a brand or as an agency knowing exactly who your customers are and being where they are. So general advice is great. You know, people always ask me, you know, what is the best practice? I was like, well, I don't know what you do, right? So what may be a good fit for one brand and one audience because they're trying to attract this type of customer is not going to be the same. So I think it really comes down to turning to your own audience and seeing where they're at and meeting them there.
Yes. Very true. So Grace, if somebody wants to find you or connect with you, which are the platforms that they can connect with you on?
Well, I'm on Facebook and YouTube, but mostly you can find me. I work for Restream. .io. So you can find me there.
Great. Oh,
and you can also find me on my weekly, I produce a weekly show, Social Media Marketing or Social Media News Live. I should get that right. Social Media News Live. So that is a show that I'm currently producing and will be on eventually. So you can also find me there as well.
Great. That used to happen with me a lot in the initial days of this podcast. I never said the name of the podcast in my first 10 episodes.
It's hard, especially when you say the word social media all the time. At least for me, right? So
yes. That happens a lot. Grace, I had a great time learning from you in this podcast, and hopefully the audience will also feel the same. Thanks a lot for doing this. Learned a lot from you. Thank you for doing this.
Thank you so much.